Hey guys, welcome back to the YouTube channel. I still remain Iyola Eritulua, your mental health nurse and the child of God. Yeah, you're welcome back. Thank you for everybody that's comment on this assignment. Thank you for your like and thank you for your comments. And thank you to those that are subscribing to it and those only their notification. I really appreciate it. Thank you so much. That really goes a long way with me. Now we want to do something very interesting today. You see, there is a cultural value, okay, probably from where I came from. Yeah, there's a cultural ideology about mental health and mental illness. You see, people don't just want to hear, oh, I'm going to this particular hospital that is treating or is a specialist in mental illness. So they are always like, oh, where are you going? What do you want to go and do there? You know, this, or they begin to segregate you, stigmatize you. Of course, knowledge is getting better right now, but then there's still stigmatization around it. Now, we believe that if anybody comes down with mental illness, there are those people that we see on the road, there are those people we see holding rubbish, there are those people we see talking to self. You know, it took me time to really understood that, and it was when I got to the specialty that I learned. I've really met some people that were actually developing mental illness while I was growing up, and at some point or the other, we did not know it was mental illness. You know, I grew up in a place where we have people that would just come with this idea of I'm the richest man in the world, you know, children now just be calling, you're the richest man, yes. So, and when you see that man walking, say, hey, the rich man in the world. Only did I know that was just a sign of mental illness. You see, just realize we have this all around us, and because our knowledge and awareness is not grounded, it's not sound, we don't know. Now, this can continue on and on. Mental illness is not when someone committed suicide. No, it's not when someone goes out naked. It's not when everybody starts shouting, oh, he has left the house, so he's naked. Oh, yeah, mental illness does not need to get to that place before we make do with something, before we do something to it. Now, mental illness can be as simple as someone getting a job and leaving a job in the next 6 months without anything in mind, just sitting at home, getting another one and leaving it to another one. It can be that. Mental illness can even be loss of interest in life and activity. And you see, when somebody begins to lose interest in life and activity, they eventually commit suicide. And to be like, ah, oh, you just committed suicide. No, something was coming up. Now it's the same thing with, okay, I just woke up one day and I realized I'm having a headache. Before I begin to have a headache, there are some things that was happening in my system. There was something that was happening inside of me, in my bloodstream. Malaria parasites was there, growing its seed. That's the best way I can explain it, because I know everybody watching this cannot be a nurse and cannot be a doctor, cannot be a health worker. Growing its seed, growing a child inside my bloodstream and perpetuating, moving on and until it gets to a point and I say, oh, I'm having a headache, let me go and treat myself. Do you understand? So today I really don't want to sound religious, because that's not what I do. I want to sound spiritual, and I want us to really understand the place of Bible in our mental health. And it is not, like I said, it is not until we find this odd behavior around us that we know and accept mental illness. No, mental health is a journey from mental health. Like I said in the previous post, that mental health is the wellness, mental illness is the illness, and it's possible for man to journey down there or journey backward, and which is justice. So what's the place of my Bible in my mental health? Do you know the Bible really did not really record mental health? Yeah, but the Bible spoke about some important things, that like the heart, the mind. We may not say the brain there, the heart, the mind, the soul, and all this in one way or the emotion, all this in one way or the other make up the mental health is closely related, or is the scientific language that can give us what the Bible is trying to talk about. Take over my heart, take over my mind. I give my heart to you, I give my mind to you. That is it. And when the Bible says heart, when the Bible says mind, when the Bible says soul, it's saying mental health, or mental health at some point is saying all of this thing. So, and if we look at the scripture, we realize that often and on, the Bible kept talking about the mind, the Bible kept talking about the soul, the Bible kept talking about the heart. And the Bible says the heart of man is desperately wicked. Who can know it? Now, it was one of the reasons why God had to cause a flood when he looked down and saw the desperation, the wickedness in the heart of man, and he felt, oh no, this is not what I created, this is not what I had. God probably was not, the scriptures do not tell us God was looking at their body, God was looking at their mind, God was looking at their heart, God was looking at what's inside them, God was looking at the thought in their heart, and he felt, oh, this is not what I made, this is not what I created. Now let me have a cleansing, let me have a new world, let me have a new life. And afterward, God repented and said, oh no, I don't want to do this again, I don't want to cause my creature to die, I don't want to cause man made in my image to die. And in the beginning, God said, I made man in my image and after my likeness. So which means that God has emotion, God has a thought, God thinks. The Bible says, I know the thought I have towards you. There are some theories that says that God does not think, does not have emotion. He does have emotion, he does things, he does things. He said, I am a jealous God. He has emotion. The only thing about him and us is that we don't, he's not expressing his emotion, his thoughts like human, not human, because it's God. We must express it like him. And I'm trying to lay down some foundation so that we can really understand where I'm going to on the subject of my Bible and my mental health. When I gave my life to Christ, one of those things I came to realize is that God really wanted to deal with what is inside of me. God really wants to walk inside out. You know, the scripture says that it is God walking in us, both to will and to do of his good pleasure. Yeah, whatever that is, a walking inside, there should be a walking inside that must beat outside. It's not a walking outside that we've gone through some things, because we've had some thoughts, because we've made some decisions, because we have felt somehow at some point or the other. And now what the scripture wants to do to us is to teach us. Remember in 2 Timothy chapter 3 verse 16, which is scripture, is all scripture is the breath and inspiration of God that's profitable to man in doctrine, in reproach, in teaching, and all of that. So what the scripture wants to do to us is to teach us through those processes, is to guide us through those phases in our thoughts, is to guide us through them. It is trying to work it out now. So if what we do to the scripture is to come to it today and not tomorrow and day after tomorrow, one thing we are doing is that we are shaking the ground. We are shaking the ground. We are not making it firm, and we are exposing ourselves as a child of God, because we've gone through challenges, we've gone through bitterness, we've gone through things that we never really felt it got through us. Now, I remember one of those, my period of counseling, and someone, we usually have a Bible reading every week. So one day I told her to come up with the scripture, and the scripture she came up with is, I've really forgotten that, and just talking about, do not be anxious, I think it's in Matthew, and when we begin to explain that scripture, and I begin to ask her, why would God say you should not be anxious and all of the likes? And of course, we've been dealing with the issue of faith before that time. And she said, wow. So God feels the way I feel. Like, she said, wow. Do you know, at every point I am afraid, at every point I am scared, at every point I turn to the Bible, this is what I see. I see the Lord telling me, don't be afraid. But you know, I still stay afraid. I'm still anxious. I'm still scared. And she was like, oh, I've been missing a treasure. And I said, no. The truth is, God knows your state. and it will bring the word for it at time and in season. And it is now left for us to choose to do what the word says we should do. Now, and the reason why it might have felt the scripture was not handling what we presented to it is because we did not take the decision to hold on to it. We did not take the decision to abide with it. So I'm bringing the Bible to our mental health. I'm bringing the Bible to the way we feel. I'm bringing the Bible to the way we think. I'm bringing the Bible to the experiences we've had in life, to the disappointments we've had in life, to the upbringing that are faulty, to the family values that are not edifying. I'm bringing the Bible to it. So when we come to Christ, when we give our life to Christ and we find ourselves at any point in time, we must come to realize that what we need is God, what we need is Holy Spirit, and what we need is the scripture, because it's an inspiration of God. You see, one of those things that got me while I was reading that scripture, that 2 Timothy 3:16 is all scripture is the inspiration of God. As if I should say, all scripture is the breath of God. And I remember at Genesis, when God wanted to make man, when he was making man, he breathed into them. And I am thinking that why we Paul talk about scripture as the breath of God, because it is the breath of God. It is his breathing. It is his. And it was his breath that made us a living soul. And to be a living soul, we need the scripture. To stay a living soul, we need the scripture. Because it will teach us. It will correct us. You see, like when I give my life to Christ, one of those lessons I can't forget is God telling me to be teachable. And my personality structure is not the type that can sit somewhere. So it took, like, I went through that scriptural teaching for almost months. Like, when I come here, it's teachable. I was unconscious at some point. Like, I didn't know the Bible was telling me that. And later I had to pay my mind to it. Like, Maybe we should first... Maybe we should first expect the scripture to deal with who we are, than attempting to read the scripture in this aura, supernatural, I don't know how to say it, because I can't express it, I can understand the approach we used to take to the scripture. You know, people will go to the Bible and say, oh, I want to read the Bible because I want to become a Kenneth Hagin. I want to become Kenneth Copeland. I want to dissect the scripture. Yes, we do need to dissect the scripture. But then we needed scripture to deal with our person. We needed scripture to deal with everything about us, everything we've gone through. Because, see, the truth is, whatever we have gone through at some point becomes everything in us. It becomes us. And that us can be a journey into mental illness. That us can be a journey into an abnormality. Now, when we attend to scripture, when we read the Bible, it begins to expose us. It begins to deal with what man cannot deal in us. It begins to deal with what we can deal with ourselves. And that is when we have to read scripture in an open mind. Now, I took some research work to ask people what they think about the scripture and everything. It was a wonderful response, and I really appreciate everybody that has helped me through that small research. And it begins to make me see how people see the scripture is a sword, is a word of God, is the gospel. It's so beautiful to see that. And I just desire that by the time we are reading the scripture, we are reading it in the who we are. We are reading it as who we are. We are not coming shielded. We are not coming protected. We are coming to know that I'm coming to a world that wants to give me a final say. I'm coming to a world that wants to help me through. I'm coming to a world that will deal with me. And you know, the scripture says that in 3 John chapter 1 verse 2, being good as your soul prosperity. And let me say, our soul prosperity is with that mental wellness. At that point, it was a word that be in good health because you have a sound mental health, because you have a sound mind, because you have a sound emotion, you have a sound will. And this is, on this note, I want to end this session and encourage us that at every point we see the scripture, the first thing we must always bear in mind is this word of God should deal with me. This word of God should help me through my mental state, should help me through things I've gone through, should help me through my mood swing, should help me through, you know, it should help me through my bitterness, should help me through my fear. And by the time I begin to see it that way, see, God will come to you in that way. But if you see it with something you want to read in the you know, that majestic nature, that supernatural nature, you will not be able to comprehend the scripture. And when people come to me and say, I've been weak, I've not been reading my scripture very well, I want to ask them, what do you really want to read? What do you really want to read? Do you want to read do you want to read to get a healing power like Jesus, or do you want to read it to help you? Because the more it helps you, the more the healing power of Jesus is established in you. And I pray the Lord keeps helping us. Thank you for subscribing. Thank you for the viewers. I really want to appreciate everybody that is viewing this, even if you're not commenting, if you're not liking it. Thank you for taking out your time to view it. This is the long one. Thank you for staying through. I love you. Bye bye.